Hello everyone, I'm Abderrahmane Gelzim, a PhD student at San De Mateo of Mean Paritech School, and I'm studying crack deviation in thick rolled plates of 2050T8 aluminium alloy under the supervision of Vincent Morel and Alain Coster from San De Mateo, Vincent Carutini from ONERA, the French Aerospace Lab, and Eran Bernizri from Constellium, which is the industrial partner of this work. I will start by presenting the industrial context. The application field of the study material is aircraft structures, mainly the fuselage and the wings. As you can see in these images, there is a rear spar and a front spar and wing ribs. And here we can see fuselage frames. Multifunctional materials are needed for aircraft structures since these parts require low density, damage tolerance, and mechanical and corrosion resistance. Integral structures are used since they present low production costs, improved stiffness, and reduced assembly complexity, which means less crack initiation sites. Integral structures are usually machined from thick plates produced by rolling process. The study material is in form of a 128mm thick plate. A specific coordinate system is associated to the rolled plates, with L the rolling direction, T the long transverse direction, and S the thickness direction. In the LS plane, and in some conditions, fatty crack growth is characterized by a crack deviation. For instance, for specimens oriented at 60 and 90 degrees, the crack tends to realign with the rolling direction, despite unfavorable loading direction. The study aims to identify parameters governing crack path in 2050 aluminium alloys in order to propose a criterion taking into account crack deviation. After exposing the material and methods I have used, I will focus in this presentation on the effect of stress level, T-stress, and plasticity on both crack path and crack growth rate. Material and methods. The 2050 is an aluminium copper lithium alloy. The addition of 1% of lithium in the composition improves the material performances while reducing its density. The rolling process has a big impact on the microstructure, where grains are elongated in the L direction, so the rolling direction. It also introduces mechanical anisotropy. The best mechanical performances are obtained in the principal directions of the LS plane, so in the rolling direction, the L direction, which is the blue curve, and in the toward the through thickness direction, which is the red curve, the S direction. Considering ultimate strengths, a maximum difference of 75 megapascals is observed. Fatigue crack propagation tests were performed on compact tension and central crack tension specimens. The CT specimen on the left has a thickness of 10 millimeters. Electric potential difference technique is used to monitor crack size propagation. These two holes allow the electric current flow. The electric potential difference is measured from the holes in both sides of the notch. A slot is also introduced to measure the crack mouth opening displacement with the clip-on extensometer. The CCT specimen on the right has a thickness of 5 mm, which is twice lower than the CT thickness. The width of the CCT specimen is rather low compared to usual dimensions used in the industry, but was decided to enable sampling in the through thickness direction. The main difference between these two geometries is T-stress values, which are positive in the CT specimens and negative in the CCTs. The specimens were extracted in the LS plane at the center of the plate thickness and following different directions in order to estimate crack growth anisotropy. For the CT specimens, the sampling is done every 15 degrees. For the CCT specimens, only S-L and L-S orientations are machined. The fatigue tests were conducted with a constant load amplitude. An optical microscope was used to track the crack in a mirror polished face. We can see in this picture the reflect of the optical microscope on the polished mirror face. In the opposite face of the specimen, a speckle pattern has been introduced in order to measure the displacement fields by digital image correlation. This picture is an overview of all the experimental setup. It has been taken at the end of the test, as we can see a broken specimen here in the center of the image. Regarding the straight path of in this specimen, it's easy to deduce that it's a CT 0° specimen. So there is the optical microscope on one side and the scientific camera on the other side, and light spots are visible in both sides too. Let's pass now to the experimental results. For the same specimen orientation, two tests have been performed with two different loading intensities. The specimens with orientations lower than 30 degrees to the rolling direction showed initial crack deviation, as we can see in the C15 degrees and the CT 13 degrees, while it occurred later and progressively in the other orientations. Scatter is observed in the CT 90 degrees results for the two specimens with Fmax equal to 3.4 kN. As we can see the significant difference between the blue curve and the yellow curve. Despite the scatter, an effect of stress level can be seen only on configuration with progressive and late crack deviation. In these coupons, so the CT 45 degrees, CT 60 degrees, and CT 75 degrees, a higher loading intensity tends to lead to smaller crack lengths at deviation. The Paris curves show no significant effect of stress level on crack growth rate. A slowdown in crack growth rate is observed before crack deviation in CT 60, 75, and 90 degrees, which is traduced by a noticeable plateau. Here, here, and here. The dispersion in CT 90 degrees specimen is also found in the crack growth rate results. As I have presented in the first part of the presentation, other tests were performed on CCT specimens in order to evaluate the role of the so-called T-stress on crack deviation. Let's see the stress expression. We can find the stress intensity factors, K1 and K2, as a first-order terms. T-stress is a second-order term. We can notice that it's the first non-singular term of this expression. CCT specimens with a notch oriented with an angle of 90 degrees to the rolling direction showed no deviation and until a delta K of 28 megapascal square root meter. The following Paris curves confirm the no influence of stress level on crack growth rates. However, while the crack growth rates are matching very well for CT 0° and CCT 0° specimens, they are higher in CCT 90 degrees in comparison with CT 90 degrees specimens. In order to analyze the plasticity, strain fields obtained by digital image correlation are compared at same stress intensity factors amplitudes. 0.2% of total strain has been retained as a yield criterion. For specimens at 0°, we can see that higher plasticity is observed in the vicinity of the crack tip in CCT specimens. However, this has no impact on crack growth rates. In specimens in the L-S configuration too, higher plasticity is observed in the vicinity of the crack tip in the CCT specimens. This observation is still valid for higher delta k. It's interesting to see a secondary crack in the CT specimen. This crack is active since there is an acute strain field at the crack tip. This leads us to talk about crack growth mechanisms. The crack propagation in aluminium 2050 is characterized by crack branching. In this CT 90 degree specimen, for instance, the first branch is circled in yellow and the second one occurred just before the final deviation. The main crack shows transgranular fracture before deviation, but after deviation, electron backscattered diffraction fractographies highlights a competition between transgranular and intergranular fracture. This competition is also found in the secondary electron fractographies of the first branch. In conclusion, most of the effect of stress level on fatigue crack deviation is rationalized by the stress intensity factors, whether for crack path or crack growth rates. No crack deviation is observed on CCT W30 specimens below 28 MPa square root meter, which is correlated with negative T-stress in CCT in opposition with positive values of T-stress in CT specimens. Finally, large plasticity difference is measured between specimens with no effect on crack growth rates in S-L direction.